Damned Souls Orientation Guide, Chapter 18, Dimensional Communications. There are many ways to sow horror on the mortal plane. While haunted VHS tapes have fallen out of vogue, there are still a multitude of ways for our demons to communicate with and torment your life. A Damned Souls Orientation Guide, Chapter 21, Transportation. The price of vehicles in hell often bar all but the most enterprising souls to acquire one. Yes, they are often stolen. Yes, they have a tendency to spontaneously But the thrill of driving with the windows rolled down even for a day can be worth the decades it takes to afford a new one. Oh, and we also don't offer it.
Why the boss likes violence so much.
Ah!
just assuming Satan rules because he's the strongest? I mean, in some animal groups that works, but come on, it's no way to run a society. I would go with a meritocracy personally, but then of course I'd rule it. And I don't want those kind of headaches.
Lights up! The mortal stands in the training grounds, eager to try out his new force stomp power on the group of demons in front of them.
Your prayers won't be answered here.
Act 1, Scene 2. In which our protagonist kills more demons in Act 2. In which our protagonist is greeted by foul imps. Our protagonist learns that Force Stomp even works on flying enemies, enabling them to remove a Dark Inciter's shield before shooting them to death with bullets. There is also a mistaken idea. The day is won, and the curtain closes on our noble hero.
Soul's Orientation Guide, Chapter 14, The Altor Corporation. Dane Vogel is an example for what the best of you can become. A businessman who serves as my thrall. This megacorporation exists at my leisure, and assuming it continues to serve my interests, I will allow it to persist.
This is bad. Ozymandias, you scamp. Whatever. The Silver Bullet is the only strip club worth going to.
Hey, baby, you looking for a bad time?
Maybe. I'll get back to you.
Thank you.
Dane, if this is a dead drop, you shouldn't be using my name.
How did you know it was a dead drop?
It was obvious. There are three tacos malos in hell. The words tacos malos is made up of 10 consonants. Three tacos malos equals 310. Drop the zero and you have 31. And the 31 theory signifies a place of importance. The only question that remained was for whom was the space important. Now, altar is a five-letter word, like taco, and malos, which means...
Yeah, I just like tacos.
That's disappointing.
You're telling me. Now listen up, I've been stashing resources at each of the branches. Swing by all three and you'll be able to build a weapon.
Damned Souls Orientation Guide, Chapter 36, The Dark Inciters. These elder demons direct the lesser denizens of Hell, summoning them to die on their behalf. It is never wise to incur their wrath.
Passion plays I wrote for Satan were simple and formulaic. The context didn't matter so much as ensuring that the action was consistent and exciting. He didn't see those plays for the plot. He saw them for the spectacle of murder. That being said, the comedy about Iago and Aaron the Moor as roommates was a real hoot.
Psh, locked treasure chest? That won't last long.
Got it!
Look, a satanic cathedral. Nothing creepy about that. Wonder if Kilbane's inside. On to the next one. Let's go! Thank you. on. Yeah!
Jezebel, my pupil, my muse, the demon with the voice of an angel. Oft would I sneak into her room to read scenes and wear funny hats. She would write these plays. These terrible, terrible plays, but the subject matter was happy and hopeful, and that was enough for me. I was a fool to think that those times could have lasted.
Matt thinks he can take the Trivia Night Chalice because I'm not around to defend it. He's got another thing coming.
Thank you. do to you?
I would never pay someone to help me with revenge. I would do it. Understand why the boss likes violence so much.
Rot in perdition.
Get away from there! Sick of these guys.
My turn.
Bring me the door.
Is trying to say something.
In which our heroes are didactically informed that the vacuum stops doors and towards you in a frightful
thanks for helping me secure the forge. If you're still in hell next fiscal year, I'll give you a nice bonus.
Despite what he told Johnny upon their first meeting in hell, Dane had other motivations for standing against the Prince of Darkness. Upon first arriving in hell, Dane approached Satan with an open hand. However, no matter how much Dane tried to build a working relationship, the devil only begrudgingly extended the lightest of professional courtesy. Dane had no issue working with people, but being treated as a pawn, not as a partner, was beneath him. He was insulted. And for that, Dane would see Satan brought low, and he knew exactly how to do it.